This February 25th board meeting will now come to order. I'm going to ask Mr. Battles if he would be gracious enough to lead us in prayer and the Pledge of Allegiance.
Heavenly Father, we come here tonight to deliberate about the children who reside in the Mobile County Public School System. Give us the wisdom and the understanding and the collaboration with each other to make decisions that have a significant impact on all the children in the Mobile County Public School System. We pray for our superintendent, for our board members and our teachers and all the students in the system that as we move toward the Aspire test that we will have a greater increase than we had before. But more importantly though, give us the wisdom to work with each other and make sure that we could have one goal in mind, and that is the children, because truly it starts with us. In the name of Jesus we pray, amen.
Amen. Amen.
I pledge allegiance to the flag
of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Before we start the meeting tonight, I think we are supposed to have a delegation of scouts from Troop 292. Are they here tonight? Would y'all stand up for just a moment, please? These scouts are here tonight to, this is part of their service requirement, is that correct? And to see how democracy works. So I hope it works well for you tonight, but we're glad to have you tonight, okay? Do I hear a motion for the approval of the minutes?
So moved.
Second.
We have a motion for approval and a second. Any discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Motion carries. Do I hear a motion for the agenda adoption?
So moved.
Second.
We have a motion for approval and a second. Any discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Now, announcements. Ms. Peek, any announcements for tonight?
We've had visitors in various schools throughout the week. We had Leader and Me Conference, that national conference that's been here visiting our schools, and they were very impressed with visiting the schools. Rain High School also had a reporter from Seattle that came in and visited and was interested in the impact of the Signature Academy there, along with Airbus's presence here in Mobile County, so that was exciting. We continue to have council meetings with our Signature Academy partners. Those are all very positive. And we're making plans, already working hard on plans for the coming school year.
Excellent, very good. Mr. Battles, any announcements?
The only announcement I have is that Maine's Middle School has been selected by the Black Rodeo Committee that will be in town for the month of April. This will be part of an incentive program that I have secured in order to try to provide an incentive to the students at Maine's that if they would work real hard for the coming weeks in order to raise the test scores, if they will work hard on time to make sure that their behavior is acceptable, that we will give them a free ticket to the Black Rodeo that will be at the Mobile Municipal Auditorium. The purpose of that is also, too, because there are a lot of kids who sometimes, you might not believe it, but don't know the difference between a horse and a Great Dane dog, you know. So we want to make sure that they have an opportunity so that they can see and internalize those things, and those are my announcements.
Dr. Crenshaw, any announcements?
No, sir.
Dr. Foster.
Well, just to build on what Ms. Peek said, the Leader in Me Symposium was moved to Mobile. They had previously had it for a number of years in Athens, Alabama, but it was moved to Mobile because of the increase in schools participating in the Leader in Me and because of the success that we've had with that program.
All right, thank you, sir. We're going to move on to citizens' requests. Let me make a brief statement here. I have the list of people who have signed up to speak. The delegates who speak will have 5 minutes to make their presentations. The good name and/or character of an individual may not be discussed during an open board meeting. Ms. Peek will keep the time and will notify you of the length of time and so forth. The first person that's on the list is Ashley Strickland. Ms. Strickland?
Good evening. I am Ashley Strickland, a library media specialist at Whitley Elementary School and member of the National Education Association Board of Directors. I want to thank you for all that you do to help the children of Mobile County. We ask much of ourselves and of you, and we all know there are times when we wish we could do more. Tonight, I'd like each of you to do something personal. I would like for you to commit to take a half an hour on March 2nd, 2016, to read with a child. March 2nd is the anniversary of the birthday of Theodore Geisel. He's better known to most of us as Dr. Seuss, the author of The Cat in the Hat and many, many more wonderful children's stories. His books have led generations of children to discover the joy of reading. March the 2nd, 2016 is the 19th NEA Read Across America Day. 45 million people participate nationwide, making it the nation's largest reading event. 2016 Celebration Reading highlights Dr. Seuss's recently debuted What Pet Should I Get? Ms. Peek, I would like to donate my hat to you and ask that you and the other board members explore the possibility of joining us in our goal of having every child in every school in our community reading with a caring adult to celebrate the joy of reading on Dr. Seuss's 112th birthday. When we work together as a community to encourage our children to read, to quote Dr. Seuss, the more you read, the more you know. The more you know, the more places you go. Thank you.
Well, thank you very much.
There you go, Ms. P. There you go. Well, thank you. I think a lot of us will be reading at some of those.
I will be, and I have not had a hat before, so I'm excited. I'll be reading on March the 2nd, and gentlemen, if any of you would like to borrow it, too, I will gladly share it with you.
Very good. All right, next we have Mr. Robert Coleman. Mr. Coleman?
Good evening, everybody.
Good evening.
Like I said, it's not my first time here, so... majority of you know me from last time. Main reason I keep coming down is because of the kids in training guard, and I'm concerned about some questions that's not being answered. And I hate to be the one to get right to the point, but we might as well just go ahead and break it out like we need to. We have questions and concerns about what's going to happen with Brazier kids and Chastain kids, and we keep asking the board members, and we keep coming down here asking questions and trying to get answers, and still there's nobody... seem like they're concerned about answering anything. We've given petitions. We've did just about everything we can do to get answers from the board. But so far, nobody's said anything about, okay, we're going to change the name, or we're going to keep the name, or we're going to take the kids and send them from training garden. We're going to bus the kids K through 5 to Ella Grant. Are we going to, is it going to be a temporary? Is it going to be permanent? We need to know some kind of facts that's going to affect our kids in training garden. We are concerned parents. We are very concerned parents. We want to know what's going to happen to our kids, and that's bottom line. Thank you very much,
sir. Next, we have I believe this is Ms. C. Lynch. Is that correct, Ms. Lynch?
Hello, I guess the first question would be, because I received this today, what is the future of our children at MCPSS? But I need to make it personal. What is the future for my child? I am a parent of children that goes to Brazier. My children, two of them are still there. They've been on the honor roll since they have been there. One is in the first grade, the other one is in second. I have a son that's from Brazier. He's at Phillips now. He was also on the honor roll, and he's doing well at Phillips. Along gathering information, I found out that Brazier is doing better than Ella Grant. So you want to send my children to a school that is performing lower than what they already is performing at Brazier. That's not acceptable to me. You all need to think over on the decisions that you are doing to our children. Right now, that's all I have to say because I'm getting emotional. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Next on the list, I have Ms. Myra Wilson. Ms. Wilson.
Good evening. I'm Myra Wilson. This is my niece, Raven. She has, and this is my nephew, Jaden. Come up here, Jaden. He is a third grader at Brazier. And on Wednesday, September 10th, I received a frantic call from my niece, Raven. She's 31 years old, and this is her baby, her only child. And she said, Auntie, they're having a meeting down at Chastain. They're getting ready to close Brazier. And I was like, really? I hadn't heard that. She was like, well, I need you to go to the meeting with me. So when we got there, some of these same people who are here, you know, they addressed, we asked a whole lot of questions, the truth about the name combining Brazier to Chastain with the new name, Fournier. You know, we were fine with that. We were happy that we were going to get a new school. Then all of a sudden, all these rumors are coming up that you're going to bus the children from Brazier over to Pritchett. And we just need you all to understand that we are family members, family owners, homeowners in Trinity Garden. I went to Brazier. All seven of my siblings went to Brazier. And then we went to Trinity Garden, which is now Chastain. Then we all went to Blount High School. We have families that are in Trinity Garden who have been there for 50 to 60 years. My parents, both are deceased, but my sister's still in the homestead. It's going to be traumatic for us if you all close Brazier. You can close Brazier, but as long as you go ahead and put the little toilets back in the new school, like Ms. DuPose mentioned at the last meeting. I know it's a whole lot of rumors, but you have a whole lot of philosophers in Trinity Garden. We're hearing all sorts of things that you all are talking about doing, but nobody's answering the questions that we need to know. And may I add, this little young man here, Jaden Bryce Coleman, he's a third grader. He's on the honor roll, and he was selected to be, maybe you want to tell him, you can tell him what you did on this past Friday the 19th.
I was in the smiling contest.
He represented Brazier as a smile.
I'm wondering if I can see why.
Yes. And we want to keep him smiling and happy because I have noticed a change in my niece. You know, she's too emotional to get up here, and I'm not a public speaker, but on behalf of Jaden, I felt like I had to get up because this is my heart, and so is my niece. She has been so emotionally upset by the fact they're going to move my baby from Brazier. She went to Brazier. I went to Brazier. All eight of us went to Brazier, Chastain, to Blount. And the same passion that we had when you all talked about closing down Manatee Blount High School without a Pritchett, Dr. Crenshaw, the same passion that these people here who live in Trinity Garden that we exhibited to save Manatee Blount High School is the same passion that we have for William Henry Brazier. So hail to, and that's H-A-I-L, to the new Fournier Chastain School.
Thank you. Thank you. Miss Ella Irwin. Irvin? Miss Irvin? Okay.
Good afternoon. My name is Ella Irvin with the Bay Area Women Coalition, and this is to Dr. Crenshaw. I've been trying to get you on the phone. I've called you. Your answer machine come on. I'm sure you heard my voice. We need to talk to you. because you promised us that you were going to give us a new school. You're going to put our little children in that school, also along with the other children. So what happened on the way? We got on the road now, and everything changed. So you need to give me a call. Yeah, my phone number's on there. So just give me a call.
Where did you call me at?
At the full, open that book up, sound.
457-231.
Mm-hmm.
That's at the college. I wouldn't get that.
You wouldn't get that? You don't never get that phone call?
Very seldom answer. Let me give you my personal cell.
Okay. I see.
Someone's going to take it. I'll get it to you.
Okay. So I need to hear from you.
Yes, ma'am. Okay.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Thank you, Ms. Irvin. Next on the list is Mr. Ernest Carlton. Carlton.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Ernest Carlton, president of the Trinity Garden Alumni Association. My question is to Dr. Foster. Give us your answer as to what y'all going to do with the school. We don't need to wait. We've been waiting. We want your answer right now.
I haven't discussed that with anyone at all.
Dr. Crenshaw.
I'll discuss it when the meeting's over.
Mr. Stringfellow. Dr.
I would have to say the same thing that Dr. Foster said, that is, we have not discussed that issue.
Mr. Ballard.
We have not discussed it, but I am in support of the community's effort to maintain the community school.
Okay, it don't take that long to make a decision. Y'all already know. So don't keep us in limbo. It's to tell us, my thing is we should be men or women and say what we're going to do. Y'all already know your decision. Don't prolong. If we need to go and pick it or go and get us a lawyer and to do something else, let us know now. Don't prolong. Wait till the last minute. Say, okay, it's happened. We don't want that. And another thing that got going on, and I understand that from the news and reading stuff, that we had 12 black schools to fail. And it was brought to my attention that, say hypothetically, Brazos feeds Chestnut gonna feed Blount and Vigor, and that's how y'all get your numbers. So correct me if I'm wrong, if didn't school fail, that was a white school, and you don't want all this. So you're trying to put all of the same failing students over into Chestnut, trying to put failing students from Brazier over into Ella Grant. Now, correct me if I'm wrong. Okay, I'll take that 1 minute. But correct me if I'm wrong on this scenario that y'all come up with. If didn't fail, if didn't feed Davidson and Murphy, that being two white schools would fail. Right or wrong? Tell me. I'm talking to the board. Give me an answer. Would that be right? Then they all don't want to see a white. Y'all want to put all of the failing schools into one pocket. That's not the answer. We are here to work with the children and try to make the school system better. Not just put them all in one bed and say, okay, all of these black folks over here, leave them over there and leave them down. We don't have to go through that. This 2016, we voted y'all in. And I encourage people, if you can't get no answer from your board representative, fire them. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Carlton. Next on the list is, and I hope I get this right, Salome Wiley. That's close enough. Ms. Wiley.
Good evening, everyone.
Sir, ma'am.
It's time for us to step up to the plate. It's five of y'all up here, including superintendent. It takes three votes to do what you need to do. And we need to know who's doing what and what are they doing. See, it's three whites and two blacks up here. And we're going to have, if we got two blacks, we still got to have one white to make things move. It's time for a step up. We ain't got no business coming down here every minute and fussing and raising hell. That's what they think. That's all they think about black people. And they're raising hell all the time. They are not raising hell all the time. We just got to do what we got to do. And the bold men, y'all can go and say what you're going to do. Whatever you're going to do, you're going to do it. Whether we stand here or not, they said what you're going to do. And we won't have to keep running back down here. We know the next step. That's all y'all got to do. Because you got 12 schools failing, all black. Now, if the school was failing in all three of the white neighborhoods, and I'm not a racist, I want y'all to know that. You'll be right on it. Your constituents will be down here jam-packing this place right now, raising all kind of hell. And you're going to deliver. We need to step up to the plate. Our commission needs to step up to the plate and do the job. That's all we ask people to do. Do the job. You know your job is come in here and treat the people right. We y'all told us that they're going to build a new school and that the children from K to 8 was going to the school. All right. I see that sign, Ms. T. You hired by the board. They're supposed to be your boss. The people got to sell. We tired of coming down here 1 minute, 5 minutes. You getting paid to sit right there. Everybody up here getting paid. Ain't nothing free. And we need to get these schools straight. Come to the community. Ms. Peach, you could have came to the community because you know me and Levine's. We got Bay Area women in the neighborhood. You could have come to the neighborhood and sat down and talked to us about stuff. But you didn't do that. You came and just made your decision. Sometimes some of us need to retire off of these jobs. Because we've been there too long. I'm just standing like it is. People get tired. That means the people got the election going out because people mad. I see the sign.
Thank you.
All right. Thank you, too. Thank you. We got to step up to the plate. It's time for a plate stepping up.
Thank you, Ms. Wilder.
It's five of y'all. And you got to make a decision. You already made a decision? If you ain't made the decision, you can stand up right here now and tell us what your decision is right now.
All right, thank you, Ms.
The people need to know.
Ms. Fisher.
Praise the Lord, everybody. God bless America, land that I love. God bless Mobile County Public School System, because that's where I'm getting my retirement check. I did my time here. I love all the children, because all the children are my children. I try not to discriminate, but I love my neighborhood children just a wee bit more than I love the ones that are not in the neighborhood. My son went to Brazier. My sisters, my brothers, my kinfolks, everybody went to Brazier. We went to Chastain when it was Trinity Garden School. We went to Blount because they changed Trinity Garden School children to go to Blount. We went over there. We integrated Blount with more black folks. We did not like the idea of taking the high school children out of Trinity Gardens, because when you move the schools out of the neighborhood, you are tearing up the neighborhood. Now we find out this year there's a strong possibility that the elementary children, you already have taken the high school, the elementary children might get moved out. We're in the red zone now. This is the red zone. We were in the green zone, just moving around, you know, and then we went from green to caution. Now we're in the red. We got to stop and pay attention. Red when the lights turn red, that means stop. So we're in the red zone now. We're asking a question. And I wasn't even concerned about the sister talk about 12 other schools. That wasn't my concern last month, because I didn't even, you know, ignorance is bliss. The Bible says you perish for lack of knowledge. I didn't know we had 12 schools failing, because I wasn't keeping up with the other 12. But then I find out Blunt is failing, and I remember when Blunt failed in the 80s. We're repeating history again. Why is Blunt now failing again? I can't understand that. Williamson is failing. I can't understand that. I said there are 8 middle schools, 1 elementary school, and 3 high schools that are failing. Okay. But I'm worried about the little children, and I'm worried about the neighborhood. When you take the little children out of the neighborhood, you are destroying the neighborhood. I build houses. I've constructed 60 new houses in Trinity Garden. The one thing that I bragged about when we got all these 60 new people was one thing. We have the best schools in America. That was what I was bragging about, and that's why 60 people went and got a mortgage and bought the houses that I constructed. And now I can't brag about it, because if you take out Brazier, I can't say we had the best school. If you move children from a failing school into a school that I just discovered is failing, what am I going to brag about when I'm trying to get new people to move into the neighborhood? I just need to know one question. What is the future of our children? I already see if I don't have a middle school and I don't have an elementary school and I don't have a high school, that my neighborhood would disappear. It would just go, and I may have to move. Because if you remove the schools, I won't be able to die in Trinity Garden. They won't let me put a cemetery there. I would love to be buried in Trinity Garden, but we can't even get buried there. So I have a question. Can we count on you to educate our children in my neighborhood?
Thank you, Ms. Fisher. Mr. Dwayne Henderson. Mr. Henderson.
How y'all doing today?
Fine, sir.
I'd like to thank the executive of Mobile County School Board for giving me 5 minutes. I had a speech, but I actually tore it up right before I got here, because I think it's best just to speak to y'all as one and not something I wrote out. So I'm asking to reinstate. We do pro wrestling events at Theodore High School, and we've been doing events at these Mobile County Public Schools for over 13 years. That's over a decade. And a lot of charity work. That goes towards your basketball programs in these gyms. And for some reason, we're not allowed to go back in there. They're saying because of the floor. But you got 13 years that you've never damaged one thing in the school. And no chairs are ever on the floor. I have a ton of letters of recommendation from principals. Rusty Glover, just a ton of them, you know, that's been a part of our organization. And I'd really like to get our organization, our company, the Alabama Wrestling Federation, back into Theodore High School and MGM, so we can give this basketball program that's in the red money to go on these trips and make these basketball programs. I'd rather do these Saturday night shows and the kids come to the event rather than be at your house, your house, your house, your house, your house, or your house, breaking into it. And that's something you really need to consider, you know. I mean, if you got something going on Saturday night, and you know there's not a whole lot going on around here on Saturday night, you know, some of these kids are, you know, they're going down the wrong road. But if they could be doing something fun with a family, we carry a family-oriented show. I believe that would be a lot better than not having the events at all. So I'm asking for reinstatement back to MGM High School and Theodore High School, which Mr. Romano, if he was still here, I could get a great letter from him. Because you're looking over a decade. Never scratch a floor. Never tore up anything, never, no alcohol, we don't allow no alcohol, nothing. It's all family oriented. I wrestled for WWE for 2 years, and I worked for the community. and the kids. I do a lot of charity work for the kids, and I think this would be a good thing for y'all to decide on tonight. So I ask y'all, the executive board, to reinstate that. And I appreciate your 5 minutes, and I appreciate the community for coming out tonight.
Thank you, Mr. Henderson. Next, we have Mr. Lorenzo Green.
How y'all doing?
Mr. Green.
What we have is documented proof that we did our homework. Like the gentleman just said, the school need to connect with the community. Right now what's happening, there is no connection. These people have questions that need to be answered, and it's the board's duty to provide them with answers. They shouldn't have to wait. You get paid to do what they request you to do. Some people up here are getting paid to do nothing. To do nothing. Our children's lives are at stake. We have questions. I have health department reports from Maine's current, whereas they went into the school, noted the rats and the roaches around their food. They went back. Nothing's changed. To us, it's child abuse. Where's Planned Parenthood when we need them? Our feeder schools, Blue Ribbon, our middle schools, failing. Feeding the high schools, failing. It's got to be a change. $404,000 was spent in an interest for Maine's. Had a picture that the architects had drawn. The children passed by. They over at Williamson now. Never got a chance to see it. So the people are asking, what happened to that money? And if we got money to throw away, then let's offer it as an incentive, as a bonus to some of the teachers that work overtime when they get home at night, checking papers, making lesson plans. Ms. Peake did the same thing. She worked with Mr. Keeby, the principal I had, disciplinary. He had us in order. And as a result, I'm here to represent those that was not articulate enough to be here, those that were miseducated and not here. Our children probably will be called on to go to war and fight a war for our country, the United States. But when they think back, they can say they didn't give a about us. Why should we fight? But we're all one country. And Mobile don't have a race problem until we see this. And it's not looking good. These children deserve better. And if you all can't do it, let us know. That's what the people are saying. If we spend $404,000 on architect, check the soil, and all the things are necessary for the new construction and renovation, which we have copies of, they don't have that. They don't see that. Where's that money? That could be an art music program. So something's got to be done to assist these children. Why isn't the Board of Health closing that cafeteria? Those children could at a later date suffer with from the mold, from the bad food, and then we wonder your child's sick and you wonder what's going on. Something's got to change. And for the people that don't want to change, that are represented, you're going to be voted out. And the people are going to decide at some point that enough is enough. I thank you for your time.
Thank you, Mr. Green. Next, we have Lauren, and I apologize, Vanderbilt Bell. I'm sorry, I apologize.
All right. My name is Lauren, and I'm the product of the Mobile County Public School System. I graduated from Murphy High School in the IB program in 2004. And I've traveled the world since, and I've worked in Boston, and 3 years ago I moved back to Mobile. And today I call Trinity Gardens home. and I just want to talk briefly about that. This is pretty hard for me to stand up here. I got back from South Africa in January to hear a rumor about the schools in my neighborhood. I live three blocks away from Brazier, and I've been sick ever since, physically sick. I watched at the January meeting, I sat back there and watched the elders in my community stand up here with great courage, and with admiration I watched. It's also hard for me to be here because I'm standing in the place of my father, who has volunteered at Brazier for the past 20 years. Every February, my father, who's a local orthodontist, would go for Dental Health Month to Brazier, and this is the first February that he is not able to make it because he was killed on July 13th in a car accident. But because my family loves Trinity Gardens, we are there, and this community has adopted us. I now have two children under the age of five who live in this district. And then within a year, I'm going to have to make a decision about where my children go to school. I have faithfully defended the system for a decade to anyone who moved to Mobile, to the DA's office, to others who said, oh, I'll never send my children to the system. They're going to private school. I defended faithfully the system because the education that I received. But I am starting to lose faith since I moved back 3 years ago. And I'm just being honest. My dream has always been for my children to go to a community neighborhood elementary school. I had a dream of walking my children to school. And I hear that you might be taking that opportunity away from my family. And I'm serious. We know that when community schools like Brazier are taken out of the neighborhood, that not just the educational landscape changes, but the whole community suffers economically and socially. We've seen it all over this city and all over this county. What I have with me here today are the original blueprints for Brazier. And the reason why I have these is because these have been archived in the Historic Mobile Preservation Society's archives. Because the building was designed by an architect named Carl Burmeister, and you might not be familiar with that name, but he designed about half the schools that were designed and built in our county in the 1960s. He also worked on our state capitol in Montgomery. He worked on much of the original campus of South Alabama. And I just am here to let you know that because Brazier is over 50 years old now, it can qualify for the National Register. And the Historic Mobile Preservation Society has a great interest in it. Architecturally, it's just as valuable as Barton Academy and Murphy High School. As a mid-century structure, we are losing across our country. It is just as valuable, not just for its architecture, but also the story and the legacy of Elizabeth Chastang in our community. So you'll be hearing more from us. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Vanderbilt. Our last speaker tonight is Ms. Ann Gathenji. Is that correct? I'm sorry if I mispronounced it.
Good evening, everyone. To me, what we have here is a paradox. We are sitting here during Black History Month discussing the failure of Black students, 12 schools. And I'm from Africa. And by experience, I know Black is not synonymous with inferiority of any kind. I know this as a fact. And one of the things that we hear constantly is that parents are not involved with the school, parents are not concerned about their children, but that myth has been destroyed for me over and over tonight. Yes. And my question is, what am I supposed to do for my child who has been attending Mobile Regional School for the deaf and blind for the last 8 years, and she can hardly read or write? Yet this is the same state that educated Helen Keller, who couldn't see, who couldn't hear, who couldn't speak. My daughter can see, my daughter can hear some, and she can vocalize. So I've talked and talked to the people who are given administration over at that school, I'll not go into the length of it. And finally, we came up with an IEP that stated that I could be going in there to see the teacher every once 2 weeks so that she can show me the signs that she's using to teach my daughter how to read. And we had just one meeting. By the second meeting, I had been barred from going to that school by the principal. She said that at the last meeting that we had for her IEP, she perceived that I was negative. Something that I'm waiting for her to substantiate exactly what she thought I said or did that was so negative to bar me from meeting with the teacher that has decided to collaborate with me so that I can help my child to learn how to read and write and do everything else that she's supposed to do. Because for the last 8 years, as far as I see, there has been systemic, continuous academic neglect for my child. So what am I supposed to do? As a parent, I did not study special education. That's not what I was trained to do. But somebody has been paid to teach her. And the same principal told me that if I want to teach my child, I need to go and get elementary school education training, and I need to go and learn ASL. So, what is she paid to do?
Thank you, Ms. Kajinji. Yes, all right. You have to be signed in, ma'am.
Schools when you want to, so you change your rules and everything when you get ready. But we're gonna speak tonight. You do what you want to do, okay? You do what you want to do when you get ready. So don't tell us we can't speak tonight. We was a little late coming in, trying to get in this old maze right up in here. This big old school, all that money going to it, and they don't need to be here.
Do you have one person that's speaking for you?
Yes.
All right, then we will allow 5 minutes for you then.
You stand up here, sister. All of us have been asking questions. Okay, let me give y'all one answer. Okay, to support that school that they are building in Central, that's a school that's being built in Centralia
High.
It looks like a college being built or some type of university. That's what it looks like. To me, to run that huge school, you would have to close at least probably 2 to 3 black schools to run all that. So what I'm looking at is the money is being pushed around to run everything. That's what's going on. That's the whole thing. So I've come to this conclusion, all of us up in here, they're not going to answer us anymore. So what we're going to have to do is do what I told y'all. It's Rosa Parks time. I keep telling you that, and you're just not listening to me. They are going to continue to close every school where the black neighborhood they won't have nothing after a while. If they continue to close our schools like they are closing them down, we will not have not anybody that's accomplishing a purpose in anything. So what we're going to have to do is one of these Monday mornings, when everybody get to school, our children don't need to be there. If they already failing, can't you be at home, teacher? Let me tell y'all something. I want to tell you all who I am. I'm a homeschooling mother. I homeschooled my 2 children. They both graduated from high school in homeschool. One is a trucker, and one is a graduate from Middle Tennessee State University. I have 3 other sisters who homeschool their children. One was having a problem. So what the parent did, I said, well, you don't have to leave that child in there and let that child fail and go by the wayside. Get them into homeschool. Let somebody help you. I'm telling you all, what we need to do is get all of our children, get our own community, get our own schools. We can organize ourselves. We can dissolve ourselves from the Mobile County public schools. That's what we can do. We have the power. We don't have to be afraid. Look what Chickasaw did and all them people over there. They got their money. We can do the same thing. Why we can't do the same thing? We can do it if we want to. And all these people getting paid, but yet they're not doing nothing. They haven't answered us yet. Because why? We are not doing what we need to do. I told y'all it's Rosa Parks time. It's time for us to stop paying our tax dollar, and we still got to get to the back of the bus. I told y'all we got to stop paying it.
Thank you, ma'am. All right. Thank you for all the citizens' requests. We're going to move ahead now with reports and recognitions. Ms. Phillips?
All right. We have five recognitions tonight. First, I'd like to call forward Dr. Foster and teacher Stacy Davis from St. Elmo Elementary School and Bonnie Howard from Hankins Middle School. Public Schools is proud to announce our 2016 countywide teachers Stacy Davis of St. Elmo Elementary and Bonnie Howard of Hankins Middle. Stacy Davis has been teaching at St. Elmo for 7 years. She is a National Board Certified Teacher and has embraced technology and innovation in her classroom. She leads the Cougar Club newscast team and is on the school's digital transformation project. She also trains other teachers on how to use smart boards and has received $20,000 in grants to add technology to her classroom. Bonnie Howard has been teaching in Mobile County Public Schools for 18 years. She has been an AMSTI trainer and has been trained in a variety of science programs, including Project CEOTS, Adventures in Aerospace, Weather Education, and Electric Circuits. Howard also started Hankins' robotics program and now has 100 students participating on the wide, and they will represent the county's elementary and secondary schools in the state Teacher of the Year competition.
Ladies, Ms. Davis and Ms. Howard, on behalf of the Board of School Commissioners, and in particular, on my own personal behalf, having attended the ceremonies at your schools when those awards were announced, and seeing the just the sheer joy of those young men and young ladies in your classes and at your schools by simply because you had won Mobile County Teacher of the Year. And so on behalf of the Board of School Commissioners, I want to extend this award to you, Stacy Davis, Elementary Teacher of the Year. Congratulations, Stacy. And Bonnie Howard, Secondary Teacher of the Year. Congratulations, Bonnie.
He loves that stuff.
Dr. Foster, I think they want you to get your picture made.
Thank you. Congratulations, Dr. Foster. Again, you're captured Teachers of the Year there. Good job.
All right. And now can I call forward Mr. Battles, Principal Ed Sanderson from Pillins Middle School, Cliff Grimes, the President and CEO of the United Way of Southwest Alabama, David Trent, Site Director for Airbus Americas Engineering, Jeremiah Newell, Chief Operating Officer of the Mobile Area Education Foundation, and then if there's a representative from the Gulf Coast Explorium. The United Way of Southwest Alabama and Airbus America's Engineering Mobile partnered with the Explorium, Mobile County Public Schools, and the Mobile Area Education Foundation to launch the Flying Challenge program here at Pillins Middle School. The Flying Challenge is a mentoring program focusing on character development and STEM activities. The program presents an opportunity for Airbus employees to provide career exploration, life skills, educational activities, and academic enrichment to Pillins Middle School students. The goal is to improve student grades, inspire them to graduate, and stimulate interest in aviation-related careers. Thank you for this partnership. Trent and Mr. Newell. Can you get a picture? Okay.
On behalf of the Board of School Commissioners and the representative from the district, we appreciate the work that you do for us, and especially Airbus of being a neighbor. We work very hard with them, and we want to continue to. When the first A23 rolled out, we want to be over in the park or whatever, because the park has been another contribution that Airbus has made to that community. Palmer Pillins need a boost right now, and I think that this is a well-deserved boost. And on behalf of the principal, Mr. Ed Sanderson, and the administration, and the Board of School Commissioners here, we just offer our appreciation to Airbus for you being a good community partner, sir. Thank you.
All right, everyone ready? Thank you.
Now can I call forward Mr. Stringfellow and Dr. Melody Tucker from Citronelle High School? Dr. Melody Tucker, a science teacher at Citronelle High School, was recently presented with the Milken Educator Award, a national honor that has been called the Oscar of Teaching. Tucker is the sixth Mobile County Public School teacher since 1998 to win the honor, which also comes with a $25,000 prize. She was the only teacher in Alabama to win it this year. State School Superintendent Tommy Bice was among those who gathered in Citronelle's gym recently to surprise Dr. Tucker with the award. The Milken Educator Award was established in 1987 and accepts no nominations. The award seeks out exemplary educators who are models of excellence for the profession and who have long-range potential for professional and policy leadership. Congratulations on this big award.
I've got a coach's voice, so I think you can hear me. This is an outstanding award. And like Ms. Phillips was saying, only one in Alabama was selected. We were up there when they had the whole school was in assembly, and they were just crazy when they heard that Dr. Tucker won. And she did win $25,000 and so forth, which is a nice reward.
All right.
She is dedicated to Citronelle High School and our students there, and they love her as a biology teacher, and I'm not sure what else you teach, Dr. Tucker, but we're very proud of you. And I want to award you this certificate by the Mobile County Public School Board here. This is awarded to Dr. Melody Tucker for the Milken Educator Award, and it's signed by all of the board members and our superintendent, and I can't be more proud of you, and thank you for what you do. Okay?
Hello, he kind of put me on the spot, but I do want to say I'm greatly honored to represent Mobile County Public School System, and there are some great things happening in the city, and I was just honored to be a part of it.
All right.
Okay, and now can I call forward Dr. Foster again? And Deborah Jones Kirkendall from Causey Middle School. The Daughters of the American Revolution was founded to preserve and honor the memories and service of patriots who participated in the American Revolution as well as their families. The DAR promotes American history in schools across the country, and each year DAR recognizes its top American history teacher from each state. The award is based on teacher biographies and citizen recommendations. I am pleased to announce that Alabama's recipient is our very own Deborah Jones Kirkendall from Causey Middle School. She was nominated by Mobile's Tristan De Luna chapter of the DAR. She will be honored at a conference in Auburn next month and will be nominated for the group's National American History Teacher Award.
Ms. Kirkendall, on behalf of the, come on up this way a little bit if you would, on behalf of the Board of School Commissioners and the and our superintendent, Ms. Peek, I want to extend this award to you and this certificate of recognition by the board and by Ms. Peek, and to tell you how very proud of you that we are, that you were selected as the DAR Alabama Teacher of the Year, and two, telling you that how happy that we are personally, because my granddaughter attends there, and on her behalf as well. So we're certainly proud of you, and thank you so much.
Dr. Foster?
Ready? Thank you.
All right, and for our final recognition, I would like to call forward FBI Special Agent in Charge Rob Lasky and Superintendent Martha Peek.
Good evening, everybody. Thank you for having me. I'm here to announce this year's recipient of the Director's Community Leadership Award. This is a prestigious award given out by our director to one individual organization from each field office. One of the criteria that we look for is a person who's demonstrated leadership within the community in support of youth in schools and contributing towards the prevention of terrorism, crime, drug and gang violence within the areas of education, training, community awareness, and youth organizations. This year's recipient, Superintendent Martha Peek, has been chosen. Ms. Peek has been an instrumental partner in FBI's program called Bridging the Gap, which is a youth outreach program in a collaboration between the Federal Bureau of Investigation, the Mobile Police Department, and the United States Attorney's Office. Mrs. Peek not only provides assistance with targeting the appropriate audience for the program, but also takes an initiative to follow up with the students and provide guidance. The students that we're talking about are all at-risk students, and they have benefited throughout the year from Ms. Peek's guidance. She's a pioneer in the Mobile area for merging federal, state, and local law enforcement resources with the school district to ensure a successful implementation of various educational programs. It is Superintendent Peek's commitment to community leadership and her willingness to go above and beyond the scope of her duties that makes her the ideal recipient. Today I'm here to announce and to give her a small certificate. In April there'll be a formal ceremony in Washington, D.C., which you will be given your award by Director Comey. But in the meantime, thank you very much for all your
help.
Thank
you, Ms. Peek. Ms. Peek, you know that I was a little worried when I heard the FBI was looking for you, and I'm extremely happy that everything is okay
well,
now.
Before Director Lacey leaves, the FBI is a very important partner in what we do. The STYLE program is a fantastic opportunity for all of our youth to learn how to interact with law enforcement, as well as to get to know the law enforcement officers, FBI, Sheriff's Department, the Federal District Attorney's Office, all working together to know how important it is to have a good relationship. When I've seen the students in the class, it's fantastic. It takes place at the firing range, and the students are really, when they first come in, it's for freshmen who come in, and you see them, and they're like, and by the end, they think these guys are just fantastic. And one of the things I've shared is when I go back and talk, and they say, you know, they have kids too. And so it's fantastic. And I've tried to recruit them to come in and teach in our classrooms. Yeah. I'm still working on them. But very humbling, and we appreciate all of you, all you do, and we look forward to continuing partnership for all of our students. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sirs. Congratulations again, Ms. Peek.
Thank you.
Okay. Ms. Peek, we are ready now to go to action items.
We covered all the items in the board meeting, except we have a few items that were added because they were being vetted, or a couple of the schools did not get contracts back in time. So I want to bring to your attention action item G4. That is a contract with Xerox Corporation to operate and manage the system's comprehensive information system. The services that they provide are very professional and creative to customize and formulation to meet the system's needs. Using equipment that is integrated with professional services being provided. The services that are required through Xerox require a high use of very professional skills. We've been using Xerox, and as I said, those skills have been very important in delivering information services throughout the district. This is a 60-month contract. It will extend from, I'm looking at the dates, March 1st, 2016 through February of 2021. There will be monthly payments on this with electronic invoices, and there is also a clause in there of 30 days notice on either party if the services are to be interrupted or discontinued, with a 60-day period for cure. But we will present this and ask that you approve this contract.
Any others, Ms. Peek? Is that the
yes.
only one?
Yes. Action item G16 has also been added. G16 is a contract with the Boys and Girls Club. This is one of those last minute that came in for LaFleur High School to have a senior picnic at the Chandler Tonsmeyer camp, and it's for $350 of local school funds. Action item G19 is a contract with the Mobile County Commission to accept $8,500 to assist in moving the Indian Village from the old Calcediva school site to the new site. And this is being made possible through Commissioner Merceria Ludgood. Okay. Action item G20 is a contract for the Rain High School prom. It's a contract with the Renaissance Riverview Hotel for April the 22nd, and that's being paid out of local school funds, $10,299. Action item G25 was also added. It's a contract with Think Through Learning to provide Think Through Math for summer school students, for 500 summer school students in grades 3 through 10, being paid with Title I funds for $6,955. Other than that, all of the other items were discussed at the work session.
Thank you, Ms. Peek. All right, let's proceed with G1, please.
G1, we would ask that you approve The 2015-2016 annual budget amendment, as noted in the contract, the changes are there. Minor changes that involve federal fund carryover, local and capital funds reclassification, and the explanations are as noted in that item.
Do I hear a motion?
So moved.
Second.
All right, we have a motion and a second to approve action item G1. Is there any discussion? All right, no discussion. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. All those opposed? Motion carries.
Action item G2, we'd ask that you approve the resolution authorizing issuance and payment of $54,855,000 on the public school warrant series 2016A. This is to reduce long-term indebtedness to realize cost savings on those bonds.
Do I hear a motion in this case?
So moved. Second.
We have a motion and a second. Is there any discussion?
Let me ask Ms. Pete then, what we have to refund, is that the right language? To refund certain long-term indebtedness? Did you meant to say that? Or to repay?
To repay.
So correction that should be to repay certain long-term.
Right, to repay.
Mm-hmm. Call for the question.
Okay, we have a motion and a second after discussion. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Motion carries.
Action item G3, we'd ask that you approve the resolution authorizing the issuance and payment of $80,825,000 of public school warrant series 2016B to repay long-term indebtedness and to realize cost savings.
Do I hear a motion?
So moved, we approve that with the needed and necessary corrections.
Okay, do I hear a second?
Second.
There's a second. There's a motion and a second. Is there any discussion?
Yes, I'd like to, we're gonna need to look at in terms of the what is called refund and repay, we need to look at what is on the second page, at the beginning of the second page of the contract, so to speak. I think if you look at that, you'll see that once again that we're utilizing refunding warrants, and I would like for perhaps it says at the top of that resolution authorizing principal amount public schools refunding warrants. Is which word do we have to use, Ms. Simpson? And so it's okay the way that it.
Okay.
And two, I want to mention this too while we're at this is that on those two items, Ms. Simpson did a yeoman's job of getting us outstanding interest rates too, in a timely fashion. So that these things can be taken care of, and we'd certainly want to extend a thank you to you for that effort, Ms. Simpson.
I would like to concur with that also, Ms. Simpson. I think you did a great job with that, and I think this is certainly going to help our indebtedness like that. Okay, we have a motion and a second. Any further discussion? All right. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Those opposed? Motion carries.
Action item G4, to ask that you approve the contract with Xerox Corporation to operate and manage the system's comprehensive information services, providing professional and creative customization and formulation to meet the system's needs and equipment that is integrated with professional services being provided. These services require a high degree of professional skill.
Mr. Chairman.
Dr. Crenshaw.
As much as we've discussed these matters in the work session, I'd like to offer a motion to approve items 4 through 15.
4 through 15? Okay.
Second.
And there's a second. And like Dr. Crenshaw said, most of these, if not all, except for what Ms. Peek has added tonight, we've already vetted and discussed and so forth, so we're not just rushing through them like that. There is a motion and a second to approve action items G4 through G15. Any discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Those opposed? Motion carries.
Action item G16, and ask that you approve a contract with the Boys and Girls Club for LaFleur High School to rent the Chandler Tonsmere Camp for a senior picnic April the 29th, $350.
Mr. Chairman.
Dr. Foster.
Moved approval of items 16 through 24.
Okay. Do I hear a second?
Second.
All right, there's a second. There's a motion and a second to approve action items G16 through 24. Any discussion? All right, no discussion. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed? Motion carries.
Action item G25 would ask that you approve the contract with Think Through Learning to provide Think Through Math for a summer program for 500 students that will be attending summer school in grades 3 through 10. That's $6,955 out of Title I funds.
Mr. Chairman.
Dr. Crenshaw.
Offer motion we approve items 26 through 34.
You mean, is it 25, Ms. Speaker, on? Is that the one?
25.
25, I'm sorry. 25 through,
what was the one, sir?
34.
34?
Yes.
Okay. There is a motion to approve action items G25 through 34. Is there a second?
Second.
There's a second. Any discussion? All right. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Those opposed? Motion carries.
That brings us to the consent agenda, H1. We present, as we do each meeting, the out-of-county travel for your approval.
Is there a motion?
Motion to approve items H1 and 2.
Okay. There's a motion to approve items H1 and H2. Is there a second?
Second.
There's a second. Any discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Those opposed? Motion carries.
Action item I, student expulsions. We'd ask that you approve the expulsions as listed under separate cover, expulsions 1 and 2.
So moved.
Second.
Is that for both of them?
Both of them.
Yes, sir. All right, we have a motion to approve items I1 and 2, and there's a second. Any discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Those opposed? Motion carries.
Well, we present to you in J information items, as we do each month in the board meetings, monthly financial statements J1 and J2 purchase orders of $5,000 and over. And that concludes the action items and the information items on this agenda.
Okay, is there any item discussion? Any old business? Any board superintendent request?
Mr. Chairman.
Sir.
I just want to ask Ms. Pete again if she can give us an estimate of what it would take to renovate the library at Holloway. I know at one time we had looked into it, but with a timeline. It's something that I think we've been talking about for a couple of months or whatnot. So if you can give us an estimate and a timeline in terms of totally renovating it and taking that other classroom right behind and expanding it. I was over there today and it's in real bad shape.
Yes, sir.
All right, any other requests of the superintendent? Okay, any pending matters? Attorney, client privilege, counselor.
I've sent the board an email last week or 2 weeks ago regarding proposed suspension agreement, and then there's another email that I sent the board regarding a matter of litigation, and sent an update today for the board's consideration.
Could I hear a
so moved a
second to go in executive session to discuss that?
To executive session.
All in favor of that?
Aye.
Okay. We're going to dismiss this for a second. Go into executive session.
I declare on the record that the pending litigation exception applies to the planned executive session discussion.
Let me say to the Trinity Garden people, if you would just stay around a minute after meeting.
Superintendent of Mobile County Public Schools.
And I'm Kay Ivey, your Lieutenant Governor.
We want to remind you to use caution while operating motor vehicles in school zones.
And remember to observe all traffic laws relating to school bus safety and stop ahead when you see red.
Protecting and keeping our children safe, it starts with us.
Hi, I'm Pat Mitchell, Transportation Director for the Mobile County Public School System. Remember, stop ahead when you see red.
The Mobile County Public Schools Signature Academies program offers a variety of specialized curriculum for highly interested and motivated students. These academies provide students with choices ranging from aviation to healthcare, advanced information technology to international studies, from engineering to coastal studies. These high-quality hands-on programs prepare students for careers readily available in Mobile County. Signature Academies program. It starts with us.
The quality of education that I received from the Mobile County Public School System really prepared me for global success. Being an international opera singer, I get to travel all across the world. And one of the most important aspects about that is being able to communicate and work with people. And the Mobile County Public School System really equipped me to be greatly successful worldwide.
Do you have what it takes to be an Envision graduate? We are pioneering students to be all they can be, from sixth grade all the way to 12th grade.
I definitely would recommend Envision to other students who feel the way I feel. They really work with you and they've gotten tutors and you have online teachers to talk to.
It starts right here. It starts right now. Envision Virtual Academy. Enroll today.
The Environmental Studies Center is a natural sciences education facility designed to provide unique learning experiences. In addition, wildlife rehabilitation plays a vital role each day at the center. Featuring more than 500 acres of rich woodlands, the center affords teachers, students, and the general public an opportunity to experience firsthand the natural environment. Environmental Studies Center. It starts with us in the Mobile County Public Schools.
Second.
All right, we have a motion. Second. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Mr. Counselor?
As I stated, I've sent the board two emails for matters for the board's consideration.
Mr. Chairman?
Yes, sir.
I move that we accept the recommendation with regard to each of the emails that we received from our attorney.
On the pending legal matters.
On the pending legal matters.
Second.
Okay. All right, we have a motion to accept the attorney's decision and or our
recommendation.
I'm sorry, I got to get it out here. And there's been a second. Any discussion here?
Yes, there's a discussion. I have a discussion because the last time that we went into executive session, we also talked about the pending matter, but we talked about another matter that I felt that did not require for us to be in executive session about the sale of land. And I'd like for the attorney to give me an opinion concerning whether or not that should have been a discussion in the executive session.
Call for a question.
Okay, we have a call for the question on this. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Those opposed? Motion carries. Ms. Peek, scheduling of meetings.
March the 8th, the first calendar hearing at
4:30, and then Thursday, March the 16th at 4:30 for the second hearing.
Okay.
Is that 16th, as you say it?
16th, March the 16th.
And at what time, Ms. Peek?
4:30.
Miss,
both
all right.
Meetings would be here.
Ms. Chambers, you'll get that out to us, please. Okay. Any other meetings that need to be scheduled, Ms. Peek?
That's all I have. Thank you.
Okay, good. All right. Do I hear a motion for adjournment?
So moved.
Okay, we have a second.
Did you move?
He did. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Aye.